G'day guys, how's it going? Welcome to vlog number 19. Been a weird day. I wasn't going to play poker, then I was going to play poker, then I wasn't going to play poker. It's the Australian Speedcar title on at the Murray Bridge Speedway tonight. I wanted to go and watch that. In America, you'd probably call them midgets. So a great form of speedway car. But a mate I was going to go with, his wife broke her ankle today. Another mate decided not to go. It's blowing a gale here at Tail and Bend, Murray Bridge. So it's probably going to be pretty shit there watching. So in the end, I've decided to go and play cards. We're doing a little bit different tonight. I think I might have mentioned it on one of my other vlogs, and I'm going to try and get there a little bit later. If you've watched any of the other vlogs, or if you haven't, first time, the Adelaide Casino poker room only opens at 7 o'clock at night, and it shuts at about 3:30 in the morning. So at about 7 o'clock at night, you get all the regs in there, so the games are pretty tight for the first couple of hours. So my plan is to get there now, maybe about 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock tonight. Looking at my clock there, I should get there on the tables hopefully by about 9:15, 9:30, something like that. And hopefully they'll loosen up a little bit. So that's the plan. I'll give you a rundown halfway through. I keep saying I'm going to give you a rundown halfway through, which I haven't done yet, but one of these days I will get my fat bum off the chair and let you know how the session's going halfway through. So that's what's happening. Speedway's just back over my right shoulder there now. I'm going past Murray Bridge now. Sort of half wish I was there, but the weather's shit, so I'd rather play poker anyway. So I'll catch you guys a bit later.
Tell me what I already in the stupidest of ways. But hey, I'm still young, it's gonna be okay. I got solipsism, baby, and I brought lemonade. I'll surrender then all my balance and be excited and drink tea tonight. It's not a bad time, time spent with you. There's cool lights and songs with good lyrics. We never have to talk again, whatever, up to you. But since you're putting up with me, here's another toast just to you. Let's dance off the beat and mosey up together and say goodbye.
That's right, guys, we're doing our first session update. I've finally taken a break, went to the toilet, not much happening. I'm up about 150, haven't had too many good cards. My big pot I won was a guy trying to bluff me. I had a pair of nines, I called him. He was all in for about 160 or something. And that's about it so far. So we'll head back there, a couple of drunks on the table. They're all regulars. Seen most of them before, so yeah, not a real lot happening, but at least we did an update.
Bob.
So all finished up, guys. So it's about 1:45 in the morning. I've had enough. Table's got a little bit dead, so thought I'd pack up and go home. Had an okay night, a few good hands there. Probably only got about three that are decent to review. So in for $300 and out for $530. So nice little profit there of $230. So we'll get those up on the screen, better through the old show you. And we're gonna go cash that out now and probably head down Hindley Street, get a kebab and show you the action down there. It's a Sunday morning, so Hindley Street will be absolutely packed. And we're getting there a bit earlier than normal, so we'll try and film a bit of the action. So we'll get a couple of these hand reviews done now. Sitting in my cab, what's the time? About 3:30 in the morning, waiting to do an airport job. So I thought I'd get a bit of this done. Been a bit slack with this video, so I want to get it sorted out sometime today. As normal, pretty much most of the hand reviews, it was a full ring game, but I don't like to fill up the table here on Share My Pair because it looks pretty ugly when it's all filled up. So I just keep the main players in it. With this first hand, I end up getting dealt a pair of nines. It flat calls around to me, and I decide to put a bit of a raise in the middle position, up to $12. Gets back around to the small blind and the big blind, they both end up calling, and also under the gun plus one comes along for the ride as well. We get a reasonably good flop for the pair of nines, so I think I'm still leading at this stage. It checks back around to me and I end up putting a bet in of $25. That ended up getting rid of the small blind. Big blind stayed in, and also the under the gun plus one stayed in the hand. Next card's still pretty good for me. I've still got the over pair, and I think I'm still leading at this stage. Checks around to me. This time I bet $37, and big blind ends up folding, and under the gun plus one calls. Next card comes out a little bit scary for me. We end up getting a 10 of diamonds. So I'm a little bit worried what's happening here. It ends up that under the gun plus one goes all in for $126. I go in the tank a bit. Obviously I'm worried about the flush mainly. He could have got a straight two, could even have the higher pair. So I go in the tank for a bit, and a thing I like to do, and probably 90% of the other players probably do it too, is to put my head down, make out I'm not looking at him, grab my chips and start counting them out. And so I'm going to do a call and have a bit of a look up at his face while I'm doing it. He looked pretty bloody nervous when I started counting out the chips. So that's the bit that made me call, and he chucked his hand face down straight away. So a handy call there. I like to think I read his face pretty well. It could have been a complete bloody fluke, but we won the pot anyway. Okay guys, I'm going to let you into a little secret here. When I do these bloody hand reviews, I reckon on average it takes me about 7 or 8 goes. I stuff up my words, I stuff up what I'm saying, I forget what's happening in the bloody hand. For the rest of these, for this video, I'm only going to give it 1 go, and if I stuff up, we're just going to continue on. So with this hand, I end up getting dealt a pair of aces. I'm on the button, so very nice looking hand. Flat calls around to me with about 3 players, and I end up raising it to $17, which gets rid of the 2 blinds. Under the gun ends up calling, and under the gun plus 1 calls, and that's it, everyone else folds. Flop's not too bad for my aces. Well, I didn't think so anyway. Not much there. I've got backdoor flush there, possible straight for the other guys, but checks around to me. I end up betting $32. Under the gun folds, and I'm left with under the gun plus 1 who calls. Next card still didn't help anyone. Checks back to me, and this time I bet $42. This other guy's hanging in, so he's obviously hanging in for a straight or a flush or something like that. So this 7 didn't really help me too much. A little bit worried here. He ends up betting, I've forgotten what it was now, $60 or what it was. I go into the tank, have a bit of a look, and I end up calling, and he's got the straight on me. So, yeah. Sometimes you just hate those aces. So with this next hand, I'm under the gun, and I get a nice hand, ace-king suited. I put a bet in straight away of $22. Gets around to the hijack, he calls, and everyone else folds, so we're heads up here. Don't get too bad a floppy with the king. Worry about a couple of dimes, that's about all at this stage. I bet 35. Other guy comes in for 35, so he's chasing something. I get an ace, so it keeps getting a little bit better for me. This time I bet 48. This guy stays in. Let you know, he was slightly drunk as well. And then all of a sudden, I get the card that I don't want. Don't want the diamond. I end up checking it. He bets $50. And he turns over the bloody flush. So this next hand, I'm in the middle position. And I get dealt King Jack. Flat calls around to me. I raise it to $17. We get fold at the small blind. Big blind plays, and under the gun plus 1 comes along for the ride. I end up getting the king with a pair of 8s, so I think I'm looking pretty good here at the moment. And I bet $25. Get 2 callers. Next card, 10. Folds around to me again. Folds, checks around to me. I'm not going to redo it again. If I stuff up, we're going straight through. I bet the 48, we get a fold, and under the gun plus 1 calls. Last card's a king, so it's looking pretty good for me. And then we get the old donk bet. He bets 50, I raise it to 100, he calls. And it ends up us splitting. He had the king. So the river killed me, had him before the river. Yeah, split the pot.
Let me die. umbrellas are conditioned. Come drinking in the rain, 'cause you remember when, after Paris, we all decided the best way to fight it was drink wine, dance here and pray, and make love that lasts with a vengeance. So you can join the cowards all aboard the outrage train, and you can stay afraid, or slit the throat of fear and be brave, and scratch a little edge till you're moving like a motherfucker up in this. Bitch, you wanted to fight for a cause, then go out and fall in love. Don't stop, don't stop believing in truth and grace and grief. You want someone to want you for who you are. I want someone to try to let me down.
Thanks for watching the vlog. Hope you enjoyed it. Do the normal stuff. Press the like buttons. Press the subscribe button. All of that stuff. I was pretty happy when I got 10 subscribers. Then we got it up to 50. Now we're just above 80. I know that's pretty shit in the overall scheme of vloggers, but I'm pretty happy with that. Next aim is to get it up to 100. So tell your mates. Definitely not in it for the money. Just in it. Enjoy doing the editing, enjoy playing the poker, enjoy talking to other people about poker. So get on it, press subscribe, tell your mates, and we'll try and get it, see if we can get it above 100 in the next month or two. Catch you guys real soon. Got another vlog coming out nearly straight away. I've been a bit slack, so I'm one behind, so hopefully the next one will be out within the next 4 or 5 days. Catch you then.